In this video, I'm going to show you how you can either increase or decrease your inventory to a specified location using the item journal. So here we are inside of Business Central. So I'm going to search for the item journal. So the posting date would be the date if you were to look at the item ledger entries that we're looking to indicate that the inventory on hand changed. A positive adjustment would increase your inventory. A negative adjustment would decrease your inventory. So for the purposes of today, I'll just do a positive adjustment. If you've got a number series associated to your batch, this would default in, but I will just put in a manual document number. Here we want to indicate the part that we want to adjust. So I'll do the swivel chair blue. I'll indicate the location I want to increase my inventory to. If bins are set up, then I can associate the bin there as well. Here, I'm going to indicate that I want to adjust in one piece of inventory. So this may happen. Let's say recently I had a cycle count and maybe there was, a box in the back that somebody forgot to count or that was missed. So this would be, a good reason to just increase the inventory and make that kind of true up that on hand. You do have a unit amount and a cost amount that default in off the item card. If for any reason it needs to be valued at a different amount, you can change this. You have the ability to associate dimensions, and I usually recommend adding a reason code when you're doing an adjustment so that if anybody has questions later as to why this happened, then you can associate that. So I'm going to go ahead and just personalize quickly. I'm going to add a field. And then I'll just search for reason code and just plunk that in there so that I have the ability to explain this later. There we go. Plunk that in. So now on the line, I'm just going to indicate that I want to correct the inventory count. And if I want, I can go ahead and just post that to actually commit that increase. Now, if I were to look at my item ledger entries, for the date that I indicated, I can see a positive adjustment. There's the document number that I associated. Here's the item number to my main location. The quantity is a positive value, so it's increased my inventory. If I want, I can drill in. And now I would see 52 pieces on hand as opposed to 51. Let's say, as an example, somebody had adjusted in inventory or somehow it got on hand, and then later down the line they're like, oh, it wasn't the blue swivel chair, it was the yellow swivel chair. So I'll show you now how you can negatively decrease your inventory. So again, we've got 52 on hand. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my item journal. Let's say the next day I realized the issue. So I'll select my swivel chair blue. I'm going to select main. I'm going to do a quantity of one. I'm going to indicate that was the wrong item. Over here, though, rather than a positive adjustment, I'm going to make sure that it's a negative adjustment. So this will allow me to decrease for one. The other thing is when I'm correcting an entry is I always want to apply that entry to what it is I'm fixing. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the three dots here. Here I'm going to find that incorrect positive adjustment to the blue swivel chair rather than the yellow, and I'm going to apply essentially this negative adjustment to that positive adjustment so that everything balances and is aligned. So once that's all entered, I can go ahead and I can post that. And now if I were to go back into my items, and I open up that swivel chair, I should see 51 on hand and not 52. So I'll just search. I forget the item ID. So here's my swivel chair blue, and here we can already see that the inventory is 51. But again, I can just drill in so that we have the same view, and here I see 51.
Thank you for watching my video. If you like it, please hit the like button. Click here to follow our channel, and click here for more great videos.